Every database we've created so far has been using the HSQLDB, also known as the HyperSQL database, the database that comes with LibreOffice Base. There are two problems I have with using this database. Only one person at a time can use this database, and there is no security for the HSQLDB, meaning anyone that has access to the database can see, update, or change any of the data on the database. I mentioned in the first video of this series that LibreOffice Base is just a front end and not a database, and that it can work with other databases. One of them is MySQL. We'll notice that MySQL is owned by Oracle, and some people only want to use free and open source software. For them, MariaDB is a great example. It works well. I've tried it with LibreOffice, and it does work. But since MySQL is a little more popular and has some great database editing tools, we're going to look at MySQL. I normally don't show the installation of software in my tutorials, but because I want you to know the settings I'm using for this setup, I'm going to show the download and how I set this up. So let's go to download. We're on mysql.com. I'm clicking on download. Then I'm coming down to the bottom of the page. Here we see MySQL Community Edition. Right here at the top, MySQL Community Server. I can click that. I think this download does the same thing. And another page. We're coming down. We finally see the MySQL Community Server 5.6.21. It has Microsoft Windows. This is also available for Linux and Mac. I want the Windows x86 64-bit MySQL installer. I'm clicking that. I'm scrolling down on this page, which shows me the MySQL installer 5.6.21. I've got two choices. One of them is the web community, that's 1.4 meg. And this other one is x86 32-bit. It's 287 meg. That's the one that I am going to install. Clicking download. Now it's asking me to either log in or sign up. But if I scroll down just a little bit, we see no thanks, just start my download. From here, I'm going to click save file. I've downloaded the MySQL.msi file, .msi for Microsoft installation. Double clicking that. I'm going to click run. Windows is configuring the MySQL installer. It's asking us to accept the license agreement. I'm leaving this at the default of developer defaults. Next. Now it's telling us that it can't find things to connect MySQL to Excel, to Visual Studio, or to Python. I don't need those, so I'm going to click Next. It's giving us a little warning here asking us, do you really want to go on without installing? Yes, that's fine. Now it's telling us it wants to execute to upgrade these following packages. I'm going to leave this as it is. Click execute. This one may take some time to complete. We see all of the updates are complete. Clicking next. Now it wants to do a little configuration. I'll click next. The development machine, TCP/IP 3306, that's all fine. I'm leaving everything the defaults. Now it's asking me for a MySQL root password. This is going to be like the administrative password, the password for the entire database. I am going to type in capital S-E-C-R-E-T 1, secret 1. And I'm telling you this so that you'll be able to follow along, because when we add new users, I want you to know which password I'm typing in. I'm going to tab into the repeat password. Secret 1, and it is a very weak password, especially for our root password, our main administrative password. you're going to want to type in something a little better. Let's move on to next. Our Windows service name is going to be MySQL56. Leaving everything unchanged, clicking Next. Now it wants us to apply the server configuration. I'll do that by clicking Execute. That is finished. I will click Finish. Now it wants to do some more product configuration, clicking Next. Now it wants to connect to the server. We've got our user as root and our password. That was the secret one. Let's make sure that works. Connection successful. Now we've got some more server configuration. We want to execute. And finish. But wait, there's more. More product configuration. I'll click Next. And finally, we're done. It's asking us right now, do we want to start the MySQL workbench after setup? I'm going to uncheck this right now. We are going to use the MySQL workbench, just not right away. I'm going to click Finish, and we're done. In the next tutorial, we'll look at creating a MySQL database and connecting it to LibreOffice.